it's an end all. Then he brings it to you. Creature features and all creatures and all features. And the creature gonna get you tonight. You better not turn out your bedroom lights. He'll grab your head and give such a bite. You may even die just from a fright. You ain't nothing gonna be, baby. You ain't nothing gonna be alright. Cause the creature gonna get you, baby.
''1973. Such a wonderful year. You could purchase a dozen eggs for a mere 45 pence. A gallon of petrol would cost even less. The most popular film was The Exorcist. If you tuned your television to NBC on a Sunday night, you would likely be presented with a first-run episode of Columbo, and the number one song of the year was a tune entitled ''Tie a Yellow Ribbon Round the Old Oak Tree.''
I adore Tony Orlando and Dawn.
Welcome to Creature Features. I'm your host, Vincent. The young lady to my left with the affinity for puppies, piglets, nitroglycerin, and remote fuses is my lovely housemate, Tangella. And the tall bloke in the tux would be my disco-adoring valet, Mr. Livingston. The purpose in harking back to 1973 is because tonight's film hails from that delightful year. Tonight we shall present to you a movie entitled Idaho Transfer. Directed by Peter Fonda, this film revolves around four bohemian teenagers who are sent to the future to establish a new civilization on a now devastated Earth. A frightful film which I do indeed hope shall have a joyful ending. She just spoiled the ending for me.
She does that to me all the time.
I think if scientists were to one day analyze Tangella, they would find she is comprised almost entirely of a brat-like substance. And joining us this evening will be the crew of The Cult Show, a new podcast-style YouTube channel that covers 1980s horror, sci-fi, and comedy films. They'll tell us about their show, talk about tonight's film, and perhaps even drop a few spoilers upon Tangella's next trip to the cinema. So don't go away, and stay with us for yet another extinction-level episode of Creature Features! Stay tuned.
Portions of this program are brought to you by Micromat, making products that keep your Macintosh running at its best.
This is your Mac. It's a good Mac. It does those things you like, the music that you love, and most importantly, the work that you do. Sadly though, sometimes it does this. Or this. Or this. But before you do this, try Tech Tool Pro, your one-stop fix-it tool to locate the source of this so that this still remains your things that you love, music that you enjoy, and important work that you do machine. Tech Tool Pro, the most advanced Macintosh repair utility ever.
There's a shelter pet who wants to meet you. Meet one today. Visit theshelterpetproject.org. Adopt.
Hi, I'm Linda Blair. And if you want to be scared, stay tuned on North Bay Television, coming up.
It's Saturday night, and it's time to do that thing we do, which is creature features, right? Right? Yes. We are with the cast and crew and originators of the cult show. It's like a new thing, right?
It is very new.
Brand spanking new, yeah.
Brand spanking new. We like that, you know? Because when you guys are famous and you have like 10 billion subscribers on your YouTube station, you'll maybe remember us for a moment. In any case, we are with Miss Kelly Hitman and our old friend Neil Perlmutter. And Neil, you came as just like a movie expert and cult series guy, and you've turned this into a thing.
That's right. It's a thing. We decided to go online because people just couldn't get enough of us in person. So why not harass everyone as much as we can
right. And
go online worldwide?
There's a third. Mr. Caleb, he's out watching, and he's part of the thing as well. We'll talk about him in a moment. But what inspired all this?
You know, honestly, mainly it was just the fact that we were doing the live shows, and I wanted to get an outlet online to grow it, hopefully.
That's the problem with a live show, isn't it? It's gone if you don't record it.
You're talking to a very finite audience, but if you can go online and bring it to more people. And then
hopefully they will come visit the live show, because there is something so amazing about live, you know, theater and live performances.
You could do both.
It's magical. Exactly.
Record the live show. All right. Yeah. Well, we're going to watch Idaho Transfer, which is an odd movie. Have you guys seen it?
Yes.
Somewhat? All right. Well, watched it yesterday. Say you saw it a long time ago and you don't remember it anymore, so you can act surprised tonight, right?
I watched it in 1973.
See? Perfect. Oh. You're not old enough to have watched it in 1970. I am.
Well, he watched and then he transferred to now.
That's right.
And we're actually from the past.
Time machine. You know, I love time machine films.
Yes, time travel.
And this one is, I suppose it is a time machine traveling film.
Yes,
All right. Well, we're going to get all the details on your show. We're going to talk about this film. And I don't know, we're going to make faces at the camera, right?
Yes.
All of the Perfect. Above. All right. So you guys stay with us, and you guys stay with us because it's going to be an absolutely fantastic show. Guaranteed, maybe.
Great, what's his length?
Approximately 36. I'm gonna tag him now.
Okay, wait a sec. Let me tune it in.
If I get lucky, maybe I can find him at 12 before sunset.
Okay, I'm gonna head back now. I'll see you later. Thank you.
Are you having problems?
No. Got a couple of new snakes. Where are you waiting?
Not very long. Evans is thinking the lag time of the other unit.
Can't they make it better? They use something besides chocolate.
We get vanilla next week. It's been ordered. Hey, Issa, your sister got here.
Karen, where is she?
She was in your father's office.
I'll see ya. Evans! I need 6 more crackers. Where are they?
Tomorrow?
I really need them.
I'll see what I can do. You know your sister got here.
Yeah. Hi. Where's Karen?
Lewis has her. He's removing her braces.
What'd she look like?
Lovely.
How's her head?
I think she's going to be all right. I haven't told her anything about the project yet. Decided to leave that to you.
Thanks, chicken.
Jess and I have to fly to Denver this afternoon in about an hour. We've got somebody going crackers over us down there. Nothing that won't blow over.
They know anything?
No, it's the same as before. This one's from Washington, though. We may have to give him a tour.
Not again.
Well, he doesn't sound too smart. But he is asking some uncomfortable questions. I'll be back Monday. I'll alert Lewis by phone if he's going to come back with us.
Yeah, well, as long as everybody knows ahead of time.
In the morning, it might be a good idea to drive by the lava. Show her what it's like before she has to transfer into it.
Should I tell her everything?
Yeah. But go easy on the theories and tell Cleveland to cool it with his horror stories until she gets used to the whole thing. Don't do that. She can have room 27. Show her around. Make sure she understands exactly who's clear and who isn't on security, just like you did with Judy. I'll see you later.
We've got your sister. Lewis is yanking her braces.
I heard. Who's this? This is Jennifer?
Uh-huh. It's a hairline fracture, but it's not so bad.
So how is she?
She's all right. She has to stick to those crutches for a couple of weeks, but she can transfer.
Hey.
Wow.
Uh-huh. Haven't I got a knockout of a sister here?
As soon as I can get this hardware out of here, she'll be real natural. How you doing?
Really good. Sure you know how to do this, huh?
I think so.
You had a transfer this afternoon, didn't you?
Yeah.
Got some new snakes. That's an
84.
Come on,
come on. Uh-huh.
Guests of the show stay at the Flamingo Conference Resort and Spa in Santa Rosa.
Experience your favorite horror, comedy, and science fiction films of the 70s, 80s, and 90s on the big screen with the Cult Film Series at Roxy 14. Double features Thursdays at 7 p.m. Visit us on Facebook for more information.
Did you know dragging chains can spark a wildfire?
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Hey, this is Tiny Lister. You're watching North Bay TV, hanging out with the best television station in the world. Y'all wait for the new Friday, Zootopia, and the new film I did with James Franco. Now get that camera out of my face!
I'm Vincent, this is Tangella, and we just want to remind you we've got a wonderful website. It's at creaturefeatures.tv, and at that location we've got things like previous episodes, our merchandise, we've got photographs of the entire gang, including Tangella and her hideous friend. So be sure to come see our site. You'll love it. You know, this film, Kelly Hitman and Mr. Yes. Neil Perlmutter, I've never seen a time machine where one must unfriend their pants before traveling in time.
This is a new concept to me, yeah. I feel overdressed for the occasion.
It's obscene. Yes. Who would come up with something like this?
And then yet, it's a little bizarre.
Only Peter Fonda, yeah. I guess
I understand taking off one's shoes.
The shoes, that makes sense.
Because you don't want to soil the time machine, but
exactly.
One's pants.
Exactly.
I don't know, but you know, this movie looks promising because it's so weird, right?
So far. Yeah.
Right.
All right. We'll talk some more about this movie in a bit, but first, we need to learn more about the cult show. Now, you've had some wonderful guests. I've seen like seven episodes. No, three.
Maybe. Six. Five?
Six. You've done six or five, but I've only seen
the
three.
Six okay. Is coming out very
yes.
Soon.
But you're
yes.
Getting like some like significant people. Tell us. Yeah.
Well, we had cinematographer Dean Cundy on for our first episode,
well.
Which of
very
course Dean,
right.
Dean
so exciting.
Was here.
Yeah, that was very cool.
That
such
cool.
A nice
yeah.
Man.
Very nice man. Very nice man, full of all kinds of information and,
right.
And
full of
stories.
My gosh.
I mean, what are some of the movies he's done? Like
Halloween, oh. Jurassic Halloween. Park, Back to the Future,
Did he
The
do
Thing.
E.T.?
Not E.T.,
no.
But
right.
But he came over to we're in a wonderful mansion and we're right. In the basement.
Yes, it's beautiful.
So he
well,
came to our
you know,
basement.
We have a basement here as well. So,
I can imagine
you
know, a dungeon.
You could do both.
Yeah.
But now you look comfortable where you are.
We're good. I for
know,
now.
I
all right.
Like,
so
yeah.
Who else have you had? You had Jeffrey Weinstein.
We had Jeffrey. Yeah.
Nice.
Jeffrey came by
on our holiday episode. We did a because you know every show has to have a Christmas episode and.
Yeah.
You know I love that bloke, but he talks too much.
Talk about stories.
Oh, he's got the stories.
He had a lot of stories.
Yes.
You know,
yeah.
So we took him out for supper after the last episode we had him
oh.
On. And he was just chatting us up. And it was like, you know, we're tired. We just did a show. Don't speak so much. No, I'm kidding, Jeffrey.
We loved you, Jeffrey.
We love Jeffrey. He's yeah. Amazing. And we learned that we were actually in a film together, believe it or not. We learned that as we were filming the episode.
What in God's name film were you in?
Flying Saucer Rock and Roll.
I missed that one.
I never thought I'd hear the name again. And
it sounds like it's from the 50s.
It does. And that's exactly what they were going for. It was set in the 50s.
So you're an actress.
Yes, yeah. So I've been
Are
acting my
good?
Whole life. I mean, good enough, I
she
guess.
She acts like she
yeah.
Likes me on every episode. And she's pretty
oh.
Convincing.
I put all my next. Training
so
towards that.
It's
yeah.
Well, I pretend like I like you every time we have you on. So
that's true.
You
know. I come for the hugs.
I genuinely like Neil.
Oh,
all right,
you
so you're not yeah. Doing that anymore. You're doing this.
So I still act whenever I get the opportunity. I do theater around town.
And, oh, wonderful.
Yeah.
Like Santa Rosa, 6th Street Theater.
So mostly at the Raven in Healdsburg. There's a really cool old theater there.
Right.
And our next show this summer, we're doing Young Frankenstein, the musical.
You
so
know, I've been there
hope
once.
Hope you'll all come see it. So.
They serve alcohol.
They do. They serve some really nice wines. Yeah, yeah, and beers.
It makes it easier to watch a bad film. It does. All right. Well, speaking of bad films, shall we get back to this one?
Let's do it.
Hopefully it'll get better, but we're going to find out. So you guys stay with us. We'll be right back.
Everything looks about the same. There are lots of subtle differences. They're mostly biological. Like in the reptiles you can help me with. The month is August. I think. Late August by the stars. Why didn't it be September by now? Can't remember. See, but the weather isn't too different. It's starting to get a little cold, though. But the tree rings will tell us more there. Like, who knows all about this? Nobody. Nobody outside the project. Not even the government. Do they even suspect? Nope. They still think we're working on material projection. They don't know anything about the time bit. That's why Daddy has to play tricks. If any of the creeps ask questions, we just give them a phony tour. See, Dad and Lewis are trying to get it together to secretly transfer a lot of young people into the future, bypass the echo crisis or whatever it is, start a new civilization.
Daddy can't come, huh?
Something to do with the kidneys. Lewis says it's curtains for anybody much over 20 to try it. Don't say anything to him about it, okay?
Well. Two, take off your clothes.
Sounds familiar.
Ooh, these pants are a bitch.
Why do we have to wear this stuff anyway?
Oh, they're good in the lavas. You'll see when we get there. We can't wear anything heavy or anything with zippers. Nothing metallic. Clee left his sunglasses on once. When he transferred, he almost ripped his ears off. Okay, never ever try to transfer anything more than this. Socks are okay, though. Understand? Come on. Okay, this is the transfer stand.
Is it okay to sit on it?
Sure. And this... material projection compartment. Give me your pants and jacket. Close it and make sure it's locked. Now this is the transfer control unit. The white lights are always on. That indicates the unit has power. These are the activating switches that are thrown in sequence. And then you wait for the corresponding lights to come on, and that means that the unit has been phased or it's ready to go. This is the transfer bar,
Just need to press it lightly, but you'll see when I do it, okay? Okay. This red line here, this is the danger line. Anything inside this has to be secured to the transfer grid. Can't be anything loose. Over here, that's the power switch to our main reactor. And over here, Karen, behind these panels are all the adjustment rods. They're used to keep each unit in tune with the other. They control the lag time and the extent of penetration into the future. See, we keep them constant because they're extremely sensitive. Evans has to tune them every few days. It's not like you can sit down and dial a date, you know? Okay, sit here.
Like that?
Yeah, straddle. Move up a little. Okay. Now, don't touch anything. And you can put your hands to your knees and keep them there. And relax. Here. Jesus. Where's the building? We're 11 miles away from it. It's over there. Only there's not much left of it. Tore it down for some reason.
Think you'll ever have any kids?
If we all transfer permanently, I'll try. I'm not sure who with, though. Probably Cleve. We just have to get more people. Can't start civilizations with just 12 people. You know, I was tempted to kidnap that couple we picked up on the road this morning.
Why didn't we? I mean, why didn't we ask them to come with us?
Too dangerous to security. And everything isn't well enough organized yet. Might be in a few weeks, not now.
Wonder how long they'll live.
The hitchhikers? Try not to think of them. They don't matter anymore.
You know, I think I like it here.
Yeah, I like it here, too. It's peaceful. Nobody trying to wreck anybody else. Except those who have to. To get along, like the flies and the lizards and the gopher snakes.
Stuff, it's beautiful, you know? I used to have nightmares that looked like this. Well, they were beautiful nightmares. I suppose it doesn't make any sense, does it? What you said about how we're the only ones now. I mean, if everybody else did die, some people would be afraid in our position alone and all. But I don't know. I think it's sort of nice. Like you just said, nobody's out to get anybody else. I could just fall asleep in the sun. Wouldn't have to worry about anybody.
Well, who are you afraid of?
Most of all? Everybody, I guess.
Damn it, number four has run out on us.
Yoo-hoo, number four.
Just leave it blank. Number five is 62.2. Mommy, on our way back, check in for number four.
Okay.
What's his length?
Number four?
Yeah.
18 inches.
Oh, probably got himself swallowed.
By what?
One of his friends.
How far is this one?
About a quarter mile. Getting tired?
No, not really.
Isa?
Isa, are you okay?
me out of here.
Come on.
Are you okay? Issa? I don't know.
Creature Features is brought to you by CreatureFeatureStore.com, the official merchandiser of Creature Feature accessories.
Welcome to the Flamingo Hotel in Northern California's beautiful Sonoma County wine country. The hotel was built in 1957 to mirror the image of the original Vegas Flamingo design. It's always been the area's favorite resort because of its amenities and its strong connection to the glamour of Hollywood and Las Vegas. The Flamingo Conference Resort and Spa offers 170 guest rooms. It includes 14 suites and executive king accommodations. From all of us at the Flamingo Hotel, we thank you. I look forward to seeing you soon.
There's a shelter pet who wants to meet you. Meet one today. Visit the shelterpetproject.org. Adopt.
Hi, I'm Patricia Quinn, and you're watching North Bay TV. Stay tuned.
Let's do the time warp again.
This is Livingston, and you're watching Creature Features. Not now. Stay tuned.
You know, I think you need to bury that vile thing. I mean, come on, you've been caught in this one for a couple of years. You should get a fresh one. There must be some new ones in the cemetery. Why is she so attached to that particular skull?
I think it was an ex-boyfriend.
Oh, in that case. All right, it's time we do that thing called letters, where you guys send us letters, we read them on the air, and Mr. Livingston files them away afterwards. What do you got for me, sir? How's life treating you?
As well as to be expected.
How's the staff treating you?
Very well, they'd better.
How's Tangela treating you?
That is another story.
Well, you know, she's got a big heart. She just doesn't use it enough. All right, first letter. Mark Scarborough in Sacramento. He goes... hello, Creature Features. I had the misfortune of watching the recent episode Last Woman on Earth. Love the magician, and of course Vincent Livingston and the adorable Tangela. However, I think we should change the title from Last Woman on Earth to Three's a Crowd. You know, Mark, you are not the first one to write with your disapproval of this film. It was not very popular with viewers, but Majinga was wonderful, right? Everybody likes Majinga. I mean, you know, magicians always make everyone happy. They're like clowns, but not as creepy. All right, thanks for writing, Mark. Next up is a letter from Mr. Gavin Scholl. We've heard from Gavin before, right? Maybe?
I do not recall.
American Canyon, California. He goes to the cast of Creature Features. It was great to meet all of you in Concord. We just did East Bay Comic Con. That's where he met us, and so did a number of other people. It was wonderful meeting you, Gavin, and everyone else. We had so much fun. We like doing cons, right? He doesn't. He's got better things to do, he says, but I don't think so.
More important things
right,
to do.
Right, right. All right, he goes, it was great to meet all of you in Concord. Mr. Livingston, always proper. It was good to talk to you about the show. I hope the future goes well. Please print this large enough so Vincent doesn't have to squint like my grandmother with those glasses of his. You know, your grandmother's probably quite a nice woman, and I would not make fun of her like that. I'm sure she looks nothing like me. Tangella is a great ghoul. It was nice having very few words with you. I can't believe how tiny you are. And such a beautiful smile. I guess that allows you to get away with murder. Vincent the Frostman, what can one say? Bye. All right, thanks for writing, Gavin. And next up.
The last one.
All right, this letter is from Ken Gunderson in Campbell, California. And he goes, hello again, Creature Features from Ken and Campbell. I guess we've heard from him before.
Perhaps.
According to Vincent, is the home of soup. Yes. I still look forward to tuning in Saturday night to find out what Vincent, cute mischievous Tangella, Mr. Livingston, and invited guests are up to. And of course, find out what movie I have to spend 2 hours watching. Good job on your new opening. Staff and background writers and staff on camera are still living up to the original Creature Features format. I would like to know more information on Vincent Tangella and Mr. Livingston. What did you all do before Creature Features? Keep up your good and hard work. I have to go get some soup. What did we do before? So you've been butlering for quite some time, right?
Quite a bit.
He's a professional butler, so he's always butled. And
I
stole
butled.
Him from another rock star. And I, of course, you all know, did music, and I'm done doing that. And Tangella, you know, we're not entirely sure her entire background, but we plan to find out, and we'll let you know. Thanks for writing, Ken. That is it for letters. If you'd like to send us one, and it does not have to all be compliments, you can send us your critique as well. Send in the email to this address that appears here, and it'll come straight to us. And go to Mr. Livingston, or if you'd like it to go to the mailman first, you could put a stamp on an envelope and put your letter in that envelope and send it to this address, and then we will get it in the mail as well. So we're going to be right back to Idaho Transfer, and we're going to be bringing back the crew from Colt Show, but first, let's get back to the film.
Isa, I think we better transfer. See you later.
cash for Marco. And another letter from your father. I couldn't bring any root beer this time. You mean you haven't opened any of them? Hey, I thought you decided to talk. You know, it would really help if you could tell me if there's anything you want. I mean, other than the junk in your room, I'm not really sure.
Like a piano.
I think you should read your father's letters. It's not fair.
I wonder what a piano would sound like out here.
You know he's concerned about you. Why don't you just write him a note or something?
All right, love.
She's being a bitch again. She's not even opening the letters. Hasn't read a damn one.
Just don't push me.
You know, you might not have much more time to sit around and think about yourself.
I don't know what I'm thinking. I'm just blank.
Well, it's getting kind of close on the other side these days. And George, that's your father. He's having a tough time of it.
Karen is blank.
Dear Karen.
I'm going for a walk.
Why don't you just tear them up instead of keeping them around?
Hey, man, we forgot about Clyde.
Clyde? Oh, yeah, we can't forget about Clyde.
Is there a pet snake? Can we go back and get it?
I guess so. Be a minute.
Post guards and suspend the entire project by tomorrow.
The townies were sent home after lunch and told not to return in the morning.
I think it's all over with.
Do you think they're onto us?
Mm-mm.
What about the units?
They can't touch the main from the reactor station. We got the power.
For a while. I don't understand it. Arthur drove Jen into Arco this morning. Nobody said a word. What about Lewis and Nora?
Split. Disappeared. George doesn't have the slightest idea where they can be. But he said a couple of agents picked up Evans in town this morning. Said they were flying him to Denver for questioning, whatever that means.
Lewis, what are you doing here?
Hello, Joanne. Take this. Nora should be coming to number one. Yes, she's done.
I saw some people I didn't recognize this morning, and they didn't look too friendly.
Yo, I know something is going on, that's all. So if you decide to stay, what you gotta do is get yourself out of the damn desert before the snows come. Where are your toilets?
In my room.
I'll need those and a list of all the rooms that contain survival equipment.
No problem.
All right. Did Mike and Leslie radio in this morning?
Yeah.
He said he was about 12 miles away, and he should be in by sunset.
Yeah, what about Karen?
She went for a walk.
Okay.
Hey, let's try for those lists.
What happens if somebody gets caught?
I don't know.
What about you?
What do you mean?
You shouldn't have come.
I always wanted to try it, mate.
How long will you last? What about Nora?
Well, she might make it. She knew the risk. She decided.
They've gone.
Styling for the show is provided by Restoration Hair in Santa Rosa.
Experience your favorite horror, comedy, or science fiction films of the 70s, 80s, and 90s on the big screen with the cult film series at Roxy 14. Double features Thursdays at 7 p.m. Visit us on Facebook for more information.
A toy con. You're watching North Bay TV. Stay tuned.
Welcome back to Creature Features. We are still with the cult show crew, Kelly Hitman and Mr. Neil Perlmutter, and we're watching Idaho Transfer. You know, we're kind of getting a hint of what's going on now, right?
With
the whole time machine going into the future. They're going to Idaho, right? I mean, Idaho.
Idaho of all places. I was actually just there not too long ago, believe it or not.
I want to go visit this place.
Yeah.
It's got potatoes.
Apparently they send us, Californians, all the good ones.
They do.
Yeah, we get all the good stuff. So
if you go to Idaho and order French fries, they will be of a lower caliber?
Apparently.
That's terrible. Are you from there?
No, I'm actually born and raised in Santa Rosa, California.
All right.
Yes,
but you have family.
I do. All my in-laws live there now. Oh. So
do they ever come visit you?
They do, yes.
Oh, good,
yeah.
Good.
Yeah,
and you do the whole wine tour thing, right?
Oh, yes. Wine and dine them, you know, as you do in Sonoma County. Yeah.
So this movie was done in the 70s. You normally cover 80s films on your
That's the
program.
Strong point, but we've done 70s. Yeah. The last film I was here for, we did a 70s film.
You were here fact. For, what was it?
Silent Night, Bloody Night.
Oh, we watched one when you were a guest.
I'm sorry,
no,
when I was a guest.
Talk about your show, though. Your show.
You
mostly do 80s, right?
We kind of span from 70s, 80s, 90s. Actually, our most recent episode, which isn't out yet, we did a film from 2018 because we just couldn't resist.
Yes.
Oh, you did?
Just
kind of out
resist.
Of protest for the Academy Awards and their select
yeah,
nominations this year.
Yeah, we had to pay homage to something that we thought should have been nominated.
Well, that makes sense.
Yeah.
So, in the 70s, I mean, what do you think was like the film that would fit your show coverage?
Well, definitely our very first episode, actually.
Yeah.
Halloween,
1978.
That's the one that stood out to us.
Oh, was it in 1970? Yeah. I always thought it was like 80s.
No, yeah. Yeah, late 70s.
All right.
78?
Yeah.
It was on the cusp.
Yes, yeah,
I like 70s horror films. I mean,
there's some great ones.
They're amazing.
No,
Exorcist?
But like the TV movies. Do you remember those?
Yes, yes, like the Trilogy of Terror or whatever.
Trilogy of Terror. Yeah. We showed one, Crowhaven Farm.
Oh.
But there's another one I'm trying to get called The Screaming Woman.
Okay.
I love this film.
Just put a camera in my house. You got that.
No. That's not the kind of screaming woman.
No, okay.
Because she was buried alive. That's why she screams.
Oh.
Right, through
that
the dirt.
Would be
I never did figure out how
that
they did
that.
Scary. She screams through the dirt.
It's kind of like an Edgar Allan Poe thing, the telltale heart,
that's
maybe.
What about The Exorcist?
What about
you
yes.
did a cult movie night as well at Roxy 14.
Yes.
And would you like show The Exorcist during one of these
I
nights?
Think we already have, in fact.
Yeah. Right.
Great
the new one or the old one?
The original. Yeah.
Because the new one is like the original with new sections, right?
Oh, you mean like the reissue?
Right.
Yes.
The director's cut, yeah.
Yeah, I don't recall which one I did now, but I know, I honestly don't remember, I'm sorry. Yeah.
You know, I've met Linda Blair once.
Did
really?
You
know?
Well,
I've been trying to get her on the show, she won't come.
Oh, she's gonna come, yeah.
I know, no, she was such a sweet lady, and I thought, all right, she's maybe gonna come on the show, and she won't even respond to our emails.
That's not very nice.
All right, I'm getting the signal. We got to get back to this film, but when we come back, we're going to talk about the 80s.
Yes.
Your cup of tea, right? So for now, let's get back to Idaho Transfer. You guys don't go away because this is going to get really good, I'm told. I don't know.
Hello? This is Karen Braden. Would you please connect me with my father? My father, George Braden. Jesus Christ, can't you just...
We've got someone on the inside. I think in the main project area.
In the main area?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
What are you doing in here?
I'm getting supplies, you dumbass.
Guards all over this place. You think I find time to steal toilet tissue?
Tissue?
Come on. Come on.
Shut up.
But why?
Shut up.
Your glasses.
Oh, yeah. Here. You all ready? Okay, here we go.
These things are tight.
No, I've been in from underground.
I'm cold.
Arthur, what do you think it is?
I'm not entirely sure, but the unit's completely out. The ready lights don't even come on.
Did you check too?
Yeah, it's locked. I think somebody spent the night in it.
Great.
What's going on?
The other unit's completely out. It won't transfer.
Hey. Hey. Go down and hit the switches, Ronald.
Sure. Hey, is Karen down there with you?
Yeah, she's here. I wonder if they could have got to the locals.
I get nothing.
They did something.
Lewis! Jen says the units are out.
Yeah, it looks like that.
What's wrong? I mean, for how long?
I don't know. Ronald?
All I get's the amber flood.
Were there any little clicks when you hit the green switches?
Nothing.
I don't want to stay.
You better have a meeting.
Shouldn't somebody stay in each of the units, just in case?
Well, once the main is all, it takes 12 hours from power up until you can get a response. Just relax, Leslie.
Well, what are we going to do now?
It's been decided that you and I'll go directly overland to the Bruno sand dunes and meet the others that come down the river by boat. Then we'll all head for Portland.
Portland? Portland, Oregon?
That's right.
But that's 500 miles or something.
This is the overland route that Karen and I will be taking.
We're going to wait here at the dunes for the others to come up the river from Pocatello. Uh-huh. We'll leave notes for you here and here.
Okay.
Watch for a flag here. How's that foot?
Oh, sort of miserable.
You aren't worried, are you?
No. Leslie's acting a little freaky, though. I don't know. I don't know why she wants to go back. There must be somebody.
You're not going through Twin Falls?
Probably not worth the effort. We'll cut to Shoshone.
You hear about the radio batteries?
Yeah. I guess we'll have to use flares every night.
Hey, Karen.
Michael! Audrey needs some help with that tent.
Okay.
Karen, here's an extra vanilla for you. Okay,
thanks, Michael. Hey, Ronald, look what they gave me.
Who?
Arthur and Jan. It comes apart like a puzzle. Only I don't know how to do it yet. They're going to show me when we see them again. Isn't it beautiful?
Yeah, it's nice.
I'm just jealous.
Grow up. Look, you should have had this all packed by now. We're about ready to go.
First of all, Livingston is the only one with any class. You and Tangela should be gone. Show some decent movies. The crap you're putting on, Bob Wilkins would be ashamed to have shown on TV. I so looked forward to you being back on, but not after I saw the crap you put on and you and that nitwit. Leave Livingston. The rest of you should be gone. Get some decent movies. Goodbye.
This is your Mac. It's a good Mac. It does those things you like, the music that you love, and most importantly, the work that you do. Sadly though, sometimes it does this. Or this. Or this. But before you do this, try Tech Tool Pro, your one-stop fix-it tool to locate the source of this so that this still remains your things that you love, music that you enjoy, and important work that you do machine. Tech Tool Pro, the most advanced Macintosh repair utility ever.
Every single one of his medical bills, everything, is just all taken care of.
We have phenomenal research, outstanding clinical care, and the generosity of public, which allow us to treat patients regardless of what it takes.
At St. Jude, families never receive a bill for treatment, travel, housing, or food, because the only thing a family should worry about is helping their child live.
Because of you.
Gracias a ti. Because of you.
There is St. Jude. Donate now at stjude.org.
Hey, we're Quiet Riot here at the House of Rock in Santa Rosa, and you're watching North Bay TV, so stay tuned. So come on, feel the noise.
Girls, rock your boys. Guests of the show stay at the Flamingo Conference Resort and Spa in Santa Rosa.
Welcome back to Creature Features. We are still with the crew of the cult show, Kelly Hittman and Mr. Neil Perlmutter. And we are watching this film, Idaho Transfer. And I kind of like it. It's like that whole 70s mood that we were describing in the last segment. Because, 70 movies were fun.
It's fun.
Pretty raw, just naturalistic.
A little trippy at the same time.
Yeah, totally. Like
dispensing with one's pants.
Right? Oh, right. Yeah. Now, a lot of
but
that.
But this was, you were telling me this is directed by Peter Fonda, and I find that rather bizarre.
Isn't that amazing? Yeah. I know. Yeah.
His second effort, and I don't know what the first one was, but you know.
You know, he's like, you know, sci-fi. I'm not used to him being associated with
sci-fi. Right,
yeah,
exactly.
Apparently he read the script and he said he just lost his mind and was like, I have to make it, because it freaked him out so much, the concept. And really? He gave it to his wife at the time. She read it and apparently she had a flat out panic attack and was like, okay.
Because of this film?
Because of this film. And they were like, okay, we have to do it. We have to get it made.
And so the main actress, you mentioned at the break that she was discovered.
Yes. Yeah, so this was, I think, most of the actors in the film, maybe with the exception of Keith Carradine, it was their first acting roles. And Peter Fonda basically kind of just discovered them around town in L.A. He went to a restaurant where the main actress, Carolyn Hildebrand, was working. And he said he was observing her interacting with the customers. And these customers were giving her a hard time. And she was just so easygoing with them and laid back and almost aloof. And he kind of just liked her attitude and happened to have a copy of the script, wrote his name and number on it and said, hey, give this a read. Let me know what you think.
That's brilliant. You know, the acting in this film is actually quite good.
Yeah.
And I don't know if this is a testament to these, you know, first-time actors or to Peter Fonda's direction.
Yeah, there's something to be said about just not kind of that untrained technique.
Natural.
It's very raw, natural, real. And they're just, they're supposed to be teenagers. Right. So, you know, they're not these, experienced in life and mature. Right. So it actually kind of works in a way.
To go from
and they're willing to take their pants off. So
teenagers do like to do that. So it's
thing. Yeah. I'd like to meet the writer that came up with that, because you know, he could have used hats. You have to remove your hat.
Take your hat off.
There you go. Yeah.
A little time machine. It's like, you know.
Yeah.
Off your cap.
And why not the tops? Why the pants? What is it about the bottom hat?
I don't know.
Maybe take off all rings before entering.
There you go. Yeah.
I can comply with that. All right. Well, let's get back to this film, and we'll come back. We're going to talk about 80s movies, right?
Yes.
Right.
Because we want to talk about 80s movies, because that's what you do.
We love 80s.
I'm an 80s baby. Yeah, exactly.
You're
80s baby. So,
born in the 80s.
Yes. Yeah. 84.
Well, you look younger than
that's when Ghostbusters came out.
You're the same age as the Macintosh computer.
Oh. See? That's why I love
something
my
about technology
iPhones.
Now. All right, we're going to get back to Idaho Transfer. So you guys stay with us, because this movie is going to start right now.
Do you know anything about having babies? I mean, about delivery and all.
I hear it's a mess. Why?
Well, when I have one, I'm trying to think of where we might be. I hope it'll be warm enough. And we'll have to have a sanitary place with water. They always need water.
We could talk about it when the time comes. And if it doesn't, it won't be the end of the world.
It's not very funny, Ronald.
What's the matter?
Oh, I dropped the ring. It's all undone. Do you know how to do them?
No, I don't. We'll camp here tonight. It's getting dark. You won't have to sleep on those rocks again.
You want to zip them together? Ronald, you can do anything you want, you know.
We've got to get this camp together. It's close to flare time. Somebody inside.
Shut up.
Waiting for us.
Well, I can't see a thing. There's dust inside of this. How could dust get inside of here? Never mind.
Close to 100 cars down there. Southern Pacific, I think. Take us about an hour to get there and back. Could be worth it. Might be something we could use. What's the matter?
I don't want to go look at a goddamn train. I'm tired.
For Christ's sake. Stay here, then. Here. I'll be back.
Okay.
Come on, Cleve. Let's go.
Okay, wait one second, okay?
Let's go.
Where's Lewis? We're ready to start moving again.
He's not coming with us.
What?
I said Lewis isn't coming with us here, Cleve. He left this note for you. He's dying, Cleve. His kidneys are hemorrhaging. He says he'll just be a problem to us from now on. He's helped us as much as he can, and he wants to be alone now, so leave him be.
That's ridiculous. Now, which way did he go?
He told me not to tell you. You couldn't possibly find him now anyway. He wants to be alone now! Elgin, don't look for him!
Hey, Lewis! Lewis!
Welcome to the Flamingo Hotel in Northern California's beautiful Sonoma County wine country. The hotel was built in 1957 to mirror the image of the original Vegas Flamingo design. It's always been the area's favorite resort because of its amenities and its strong connection to the glamour of Hollywood and Las Vegas. The Flamingo Conference Resort and Spa offers 170 guest rooms. It includes 14 suites and executive king accommodations. From all of us at the Flamingo Hotel, we thank you and look forward to seeing you soon.
You sure you don't want some? It's chamomile.
Listen, you are extremely terrifying. Just the scariest undead subhuman thing on TV, and I really mean that. But I am worried that you could give my kids nightmares if they see you, so I'm gonna have to block you. So that's it. Oh, and tell the zombies they're blocked too.
It's coffin time!
Catherine Sutherland from Power Rangers, and you're watching North Bay TV. Stay tuned.
Go, go, Power Rangers!
Portions of this program are brought to you by Micromat, making products that keep your Macintosh running at its best.
Refrigerators, probably 50,000 gallons of chartreuse high gloss enamel. We could paint Portland.
I used to have this girlfriend at the clinic that had chartreuse here. Well, I don't suppose it was empty.
No. It's not empty. They were all in plastic bags on their way somewhere. Probably a dumping point at the line. I think they were coming from the coast.
Start a fire. We're having some of that soup stuff again.
Okay.
They're 2 days late, huh?
Yeah. They should have been here today, even if they had to walk.
Ronald, I have something to tell you.
Really?
Yeah, I think I'm pregnant. By Arthur. We made it a few days after that thing with my sister happened. Anyway, I'm about a week and a half late now.
Doesn't mean you're pregnant.
I know. I've missed before, but this is different. I just thought you should know. I guess you won't have to do anything with me anymore. I mean, I won't try to make you or anything. Think they've left yet?
Who, Arthur?
Yeah.
Probably not.
Well, when Cleve and the others come, do you think we could wait until they catch up?
No, we'll stick to the plan.
Well, what if I stay?
There isn't enough food. We can't spare any. Besides, if you missed Arthur, you'd be in a mess.
I have to tell him. I could give my right arm for a cheeseburger right now. Are there any cows left?
I doubt it.
Ronald! Look! Right there, look!
It's Cleve!
Just a couple of kids at first, but then we followed them and found the small tribe of third generation survivors living by the river.
The oldest ones we saw were about 30. They don't live very long and can't do very much, just sort of gurgle and bump around a lot.
Most compassionate people you can imagine.
No language, no government, no agriculture.
Well, what do they eat?
Whatever they can get in their mouth. Wild potatoes mostly.
And she's deaf. I think practically all of them were. But they were happy. Incredibly happy. And they shared everything.
Some are so retarded they can't even find food for themselves. But others give them enough to get by.
Rand's probably a lot smarter than the rest of them.
She's almost normal except for her hearing. And a slight motor retardation.
You know, if we find more of them on the coast, maybe we can find a boyfriend as good as she is. And get them together. See if she can't have a normal child.
Why don't you try with her, Cleve? I mean, not that you're perfect stock or anything. But wouldn't she be better off with your baby than somebody else's like her? I think it might be kind of interesting. Well, Jesus, I didn't mean anything by that. It just seems like it would be better. I mean, it does look like it's up to all of us now if they're all like her. Anyway, guess what, y'all? I'm pregnant. Not him, it was Arthur. Like, it was all right with Jen. I mean, we talked about it and everything. I just thought we should have as many as we could.
Lewis said he told you.
He told me.
Told you what?
We're sterile.
Sterile who?
All of us. You.
But that's crazy.
Transferring.
But I can feel it.
It's permanent, according to Lewis.
Karen, well, how the hell could Lewis possibly know something like that? I don't believe you. You're all liars.
Okay, I'll put some.
Ronald, how come she thinks she's pregnant?
She missed her period. I think it's emotional.
What do you think, Cleve?
Not a chance. Especially with one of us.
She was rambling on about having kids. I just couldn't tell her. I'm sorry.
Sure she's gonna be all right?
Let her think about it. It came kind of fast. She has to figure it out by herself. Same as all of us.
Experience your favorite horror, comedy, and science fiction films of the 70s, 80s, and 90s on the big screen with the Cult Film Series at Roxy 14. Double features Thursdays at 7 p.m. Visit us on Facebook for more information.
Me hearties, I'm Crazy Boots Martin.
And James the Red.
At the NorCal Pirates Festival, and you're watching North Bay TV. Stay tuned.
This portion of Creature Features is brought to you by CreatureFeaturesStore.com, the official merchandiser of Creature Feature accessories.
Welcome back to the show. We've got like a combination show going on tonight, right? We've got the crew from the Cult Show, and we've got the crew from Creature Features. Maybe we should call it Culture Features.
I like
Ooh.
It.
Right?
Ooh, yeah.
It's got a nice rhyme.
Thing. Yeah.
Well, we'll talk about Kelly's shoes. I like those, by the way.
Oh, yes. My vintage
nice.
40s wedges.
Nice. I can tell they're actual vintage. They were not made in China.
You know your stuff. I like it. I like a man who knows his vintage. So
now,
yeah.
It's like I just like spending less. So I find deals.
Yeah.
All right. So this movie, it's getting better. I hope you guys think so as well. But this thing about becoming sterilized if they travel through the machine. You know, I'm thinking there's gentlemen who would like this service, and if they would volunteer. And go through the machine, they can avoid a surgical procedure, right?
Yeah, it's a nice prophylactic, I guess you can call it, or some type, or,
However, if you're a big drinker and you're over 20, it might not work because it damages your kidneys. Like, yeah. Some problems with that.
I suppose that'd be problematic.
But maybe you're taking your pants off, which is why that it's causing the sterilization.
You know,
maybe they would have worn the pants.
If this is a different kind of show, I would suggest we watch it with no pants. No, that's not us.
Most of your crew is already not wearing pants, so we're okay.
Well, yeah. they dress casual. It's casual Saturday today.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, if you make somebody work on the weekends,
that's a good point.
You should have a little leeway.
Let them be comfortable. Yeah,
that's true.
All right, so let's talk about the 80s films. Right? Yes. What is it about the 80s that produced so many wonderful franchises?
That's a darn good question. It's a decade of excess, so I think people were just, you know, there's a little bit of cocaine mixed in with their writing styles, and then
could be.
And
that's interesting.
And it's the
part of it, right?
The VHS boom, home video. I mean, you could.
That's what it is.
Yes,
she's right. What are you talking about, cocaine, Neil?
I know. What is
that? My goodness, she's right.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
It was technology. It was technology. It was not greedy rich people with cocaine. It was VHS.
You had the films at your disposal. You go to the movie store, the video store.
The video store. The movie store.
What was it called?
Yeah, they should have made a rental place called the movie store.
The movie store.
I would have gone there.
You know, it was
fun. I know.
I think everything that happened in the 60s and the 70s just kind of gave way to the 80s and that decade of these big, wonderful films and great stories. And
but it was like a quantum leap from the 70s type
it
movies.
It was. You know, we also got lucky, I think, in the filmmakers who came out in the 70s when you have the Spielbergs and the Coppolas and all these people who came out, Joe Dante, and were the 80s was their heyday, I guess you can say, you know. I think we just got lucky.
Even like David Lynch.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Right. Huge. Love. David Lynch, yeah.
I love
yeah.
David Lynch movies. I wish we could show David Lynch movies.
Here. Yeah. What's some Cronenberg?
What's your favorite? What's your favorite David Lynch?
I would say Lost Highway.
Oh, okay, yeah.
But
yeah.
I think it's mostly because Rammstein did some of the
it's a great soundtrack. Movies. Yeah.
Yeah.
Some Smashing Pumpkins.
I'm getting the signal. We got to get back to this film. But when we come back, we're going to find out what you guys are doing next, right?
Yep.
Yes.
Right.
A little teaser.
A teaser. Yes. All right. You guys, finish this film. It's got to end well. It's got to be a surprise, right? No spoilers. We'll see you soon.
They don't work! Karen! They don't work!
Will you help me, please? You've got to help me get back before all of this happened. They're all dead. Please show me. Just show me what to do.
Jensen!
Styling for the show is provided by Restoration Hair in Santa Rosa.
This is your Mac. It's a good Mac. It does those things you like, the music that you love, and most importantly, the work that you do. Sadly though, sometimes it does this. Or this. Or this. But before you do this, try Tech Tool Pro, your one-stop fix-it tool to locate the source of this so that this still remains your things that you love, music that you enjoy, and important work that you do machine. Tech Tool Pro, the most advanced Macintosh repair utility ever.
Thank you.
I'm Tiffany. We're in Oakland at the Kraken Con.
You're watching North Bay TV. Stay tuned.
She get in?
I don't know. She came from nowhere.
Yes. Yes.
She's in here, sir. Miss? You in there. Come on up. Miss, you in there. Come out right now.
To me. They were using everything. Everything was being used up.
You.
I'm a woman, you know.
All of us. You.
We could just lay. Their arms around us. Karen.
Karen?
It's all right now. It's all right. I just can't remember the interruptions. I mean, they're so hard to remember.
Karen! Are you sure that was one of them?
Of course it was.
What happens when we run out?
We just put one in. We won't need another for quite a ways.
I didn't mean that. I mean, what if we run out of all of them and we can't even find any?
They'll figure out another way for us.
We can use something else.
But what if that's too hard or expensive? And what if they decide they can't change? We'll use each other then, won't we?
She's dead. They put her in as fuel, and she's dead. So what do you think of this film? Like, you know, I knew she would like this film.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she watches these movies from the side because she knows if she's out here, she's going to be too distracting. But no, it was a good movie, right? She likes futuristic movies involving people who have to remove their pants to travel in time. All right, so we are still with the Cult Show crew. Kelly Hitman and Caleb is with us, right?
He's Caleb is there.
Number Hi, three Caleb. Unit. And Neil Perlmutter. And this film, it was a different time back then, wasn't it?
It was a different time, but it was...
I did like that vehicle, though.
Yeah, it was cool. Slightly futuristic and in its
and the hairstyles.
Very dark ending there.
Very dark.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I just found out something interesting. During the break, Kelly was telling me she was in the film Insidious.
Yes, yeah. It came out in 2011, one of the highest, probably the highest grossing film of that year. So it was made for such a low budget.
I'm going to watch it tonight. Where do we find you?
I'm one of the ghosts.
You're a ghost?
I'm a ghost, yeah. So, yeah, it was so much fun.
Like, are you just wearing a sheet, or are you transparent? Or
I'm actually a ghost twin, so there's another one of me. Not my actual twin. I don't have a twin.
Right.
But
they doubled you.
They cast another girl who had a similar look, and so there's two of us, very very much like the twins in The Shining.
Oh, my goodness.
So we're ghost twins.
No, I'm going to watch this. So
James Wan, amazing director. He's now gone on to do Aquaman and all these major, you know,
Motion pictures. Yeah.
Fast and the Furious. That's what I'm trying to think of. Yeah.
Unbelievable. Well, we have a movie star tonight after all.
Oh,
we've had a few famous movie stars here.
Yeah.
We have. We get them sometimes. She frightens them away, though.
No.
Oh, no.
That's what she does.
She would fit right in with me and my ghost twin.
Well, you know, when we lived in Hollywood, you should have seen the trouble she caused.
Uh-oh.
She has warrants in several counties down there.
Oh, no.
That's why we stay up here. All right, so what's next for you guys?
Yeah, next on The Cult Show, you know, we just released a Hereditary episode, and we have
our favorite film of 2018.
Favorite film of 18.
Yes, yeah.
And we have a new one coming out any moment that's going to be focused on the actor Dick Miller, who passed away about a month ago.
Special tribute to Dick Miller.
Right.
Yeah.
No, he was in Terminator.
Yeah, mm-hmm. amongst many other things.
He was great.
You recognize him from all kinds of shows.
Yeah.
Right. In fact, we showed him in a movie recently, and I can't recall what it was. It was a black and white film.
Okay.
Right.
He did a lot of those Roger Corman films.
He was young.
He was very young.
It was a Roger Corman film, it was. All right, so how do people find out more about you guys?
Well, you can go to, of course, thecultshow.com on Instagram.
The cult show.
Yep.
.com. Exactly.
That's all.
Very easy.
Do that. Put that in your web machine.
Easy breezy. Or you can check out the old Instagram at thecultshowrocks.
Yeah. And, of course, YouTube.
The Cult Show Rocks.
Rocks. That's right.
It rocks.
Yeah.
Oh, all
yeah.
right.
We like to like think that. Anyway.
And then
so what
YouTube?
Kind of photographs would one see on your Instagram?
Ah, so stills from our show, maybe a little teaser about upcoming episodes.
Very nice.
And just kind of fun pop culture things going on.
Good.
Yeah, mm-hmm. sharing things in the horror film community.
Mm-hmm. No, that's absolutely wonderful.
You might find a couple pictures of you on there now.
Oh.
Coming
up. That would be dreadful. Not for you, not for me, but for your viewers, your subscribers.
They might like to see a selfie, I think.
That's right.
A selfie, like me doing a selfie?
That's right, Vincent...
There you go. See? He's a pro. He knows what he's doing. Yeah.
Well, I could do a selfie like I could simulate the selfie like this, right?
Perfect.
She would be good for it, but not me. All right. So thank you guys so much for coming on the show.
It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
You guys are so much fun, and we have to have you back, and you can tell us about all the new movie stars you've got coming through.
I don't want to leave. It's so beautiful.
It's
here.
You don't
I
have to leave.
This.
We just have to say goodbye to them.
Okay.
All right. As for you guys, you know, we had fun tonight, but we're going to have fun next week as well, and the week after that, and the week after that, and the week after that. So, you know, whatever you have to do to subscribe, click a bell, or, like, do something on your television, or use a VHS tape. Right? Set it for automatic, DVR, whatever it takes. Stay with us because we're going to be back next week with more creature features. Have a wonderful weekend. So, Cult Show Group.
Yes.
You know, I'm kind of thinking it would be fun if we came on your show as like maybe guests or helpful friends. What do you think?
On one condition, no pants.